Yo, what is up, bitch? Yeah, we're back. Alright. It's been, almost 2 months since my last one. I actually recorded one last week, and I forgot to post it, but I'm glad I didn't. I didn't rewatch it, I just remember it was shitty, dog. Like, straight up, it wasn't trash. But, like, remembering what I'm talking about, I'm like, yeah, I would not want to listen to that. But I have some pretty big I got some ideas here. And those ideas pretty much consist of some ideas for YouTube. But at the same time, I don't really get urges to be like, oh, I want to make a YouTube video. I get an urge like every couple months. That's kind of what I've been doing. But yeah, I have a couple. I want to go and do like, really shitty restaurants. Like, the shittiest places. I saw one the other day on... I was going to some breakfast place with, like, my grandmother. Show you, meme. I was going to breakfast, and on the way I saw this, like, I think it was a diner or some shit. It looked so run down and gross, but it was open. And, oh my god, I should go eat there and see if I get food poisoning. That's great content. Too bad I don't have a camera. That's, kind of a yikes, and I don't know, I have these in, if I'm not gonna be listening to fucking, I couldn't figure out the lo-fi, it's not like I tried that hard, I just kind of gave up after, like, not being able to on the first try, because I don't really give a shit. But yeah, the moral story is that that's definitely an option for me. I don't know of many shitty restaurants around here, but, because I don't live in, like, a city. But, yeah, I mean, there's definitely some restaurants that aren't that good, but I don't think any that are worthy of me. There's this one place in my town, it's, like, Thai food, and I've never seen a car there besides the, like, the people that own it. Not once. I mean, I don't see it, like, every day, but, like, I've seen it a fair amount of times, probably at least 100 times, at least, and never seen it, never seen a soul there, not once. It has to be a front for something, right? Am I overthinking it? Did they just cook really bad food, or is it literally just a front? Well, I mean, even if it was a front, I feel like, at least maybe I'd see people there, at least one. You know? Maybe there's a secret fucking drug cartel in my town. Anyways, I have another idea. I'll call it job hopping. But the job I just got, actually, I like it there. So, I make good money, and it's slightly more than tolerable. Like, it's good, you know what I mean? It's like, I don't think I could find a much better job at 16. Obviously, hopefully I get a better job than fucking bussing tables, but I don't mind it right now. Part of me wishes I hated it, because I just want to, just work a job for, like, 2 months, and just move on to the next one in every industry, and just, like, I got the restaurant one going now. I had the grocery store. I don't know what will be next. Probably retail of some sort. Ugh. Yeah. But, yeah, pretty much the worst parts of my job don't probably, like, probably the customers, I guess? Maybe. I mean, like, there are a lot of regulars at the restaurant I work at, and I like all of them. I mean, I'm not, like, fucking boys with them. I'm not, like, I only know some of their names, but, like, yeah, they're not the issue. It's some people that just... It's the people that before even talking to them, you just know. You're like, oh. And if I say have a nice day, say thank you or some shit. Or have a nice day, you too. Like, come on, man. But anyways, back to the job hopping thing. Yeah, that's... You know, summer's coming up. What if I just worked a little less at the place I'm working at now and just worked... Like, what if I worked twice a week at the place I'm working at now? Once or twice a week at the other place. Hmm? That work. That might work. That might just work. No, there's another thing I was thinking of. I think of a lot of shit. I've said this a lot to people. If the average person just had my brain, I think they would... I don't even know what they'd do. I think they'd just explode. I don't think a normal person could handle my brain. One, I think some fucked up... Not like I'm gonna shoot this place up or anything like that. But like I'm always thinking like if I did, how would I do it? Okay. Now, do I mean it's always that? No. Does that come up often? No, it does not. You know. But it's happened a couple times. You know, I mean, like just like how would you do it? I mean, it's not like would I do it? No, that's awful. I couldn't even picture. I mean, I don't have a gun. So that'd be the first obstacle. But I couldn't even imagine. The only way I'd be able to kill a person is if they're a killer themselves and they didn't have much family. Because, you know, some people are like, oh, if they're a rapist. I mean, like, this is kind of an extreme example. Like, if they're a rapist, I hope they fucking die. It's like, yeah, I mean, I agree. But, like, or they, I'd kill them myself. Like, I don't really want to kill people in any circumstance whatsoever. A little. No, I'm just kidding. But, yeah. But especially if they have family, because think of how many people... A death can affect so many people just beyond immediate family. Extended family, especially in friends, too. Like, it can really fuck people up. Like, really hard. Not just being sad. Like, it can fuck people up. Like, that shit's fucked. So what I... No, I wouldn't. I would never do that. Anyways, some of the other thoughts, I think. Is the worst thing. Just the worst imaginable stuff that could happen. Just, I think of it. Like, for example, I think I hit a pothole yesterday. And I was, like, 99% sure that it was a pothole. But I'm like, what if that was a kid? What if that was a little boy? What, did I just kill someone? Should I go back and check? Oh, I literally can like convince myself I hit a little fucking 3-year-old at 4:30 in the morning, or like 5:15 in the morning. Like, who the fuck does that, man? And that whole thing I just talked about was so that I could try and help myself remember what I forgot before, but that didn't work. So I had that jaw-popping thing. We had that other thing. Oh, about going to shitty restaurants. What was that fucking third thing, dog? Oh! Thought of it this morning. Like, 5, so. I don't really... Can't really even blame myself. Well, actually, I can. I should have wrote it down. But, yeah. I don't remember what I talked about on the last one. Oh, my God. I remember what I talked about. I talked about teachers and school. No wonder it was fucking boring. No. I could. No, I don't want to talk about school. I don't know what I want to talk about. Oh, yeah, I know what I want to talk about. Would you rathers are the stupidest shit ever, okay? Because they're so open-ended. Like, not even open-ended. You can make an argument for either, no matter what it is. I don't care what it is. Or would you rather, when you bring in hypotheticals, I can argue at any point, no matter what it is. Okay, kill a kid or get $1 million. Kill the kid. Why? Cause he's a descendant of Hitler, actually, and that's actually not a very good reason. Shit, he's innocent. He's a rapist himself. Yeah, he's a rapist. Yeah, the little kid's a rapist. Yeah, that one works. What else? I don't really know, man. But, yeah. So, trying to keep this interesting, because I don't know what to talk about. But, why drag this out to 30 minutes? Why can't I just talk, you know? Since when can a kid talk? Just a kid, man. Just a kid. Oh, also, I used to have this catchphrase. I don't know, man, I just work here. Got it from a YouTuber I used to watch. And, you know, it's a phrase I really want to use at work. But, I can't really, I'd probably get fired. Well, I wouldn't get fired, but I just get yelled at. So, I mean, is it worth it? No. Is worth doing this channel even worth it? You tell me. You tell me, man. Because at the end of the day, we are all one. Americans, you may say? No. Humans? No. We are all one singular person. We're nothing. Okay, I was thinking earlier. What if we are in a simulation because another species wanted to learn about their upcoming and how they came to life? You know, things like evolution and things like the... I don't even know, like the Big Bang. I don't even know. What if another, not species, I guess, but another fucking reality, or the real reality, created us in the simulation so that they could understand their origin? And what if the people before that, they're in a simulation because the people before them wanted to know about their past? At the end of the day, what does this mean? I don't know. Is this possible? Probably not. But does it make sense? Kind of. But this, a question arises. Who were the first people? Is this even real? Is this real? You know, some people, like personally, I'm not religious, any of that shit. But what if, just what if, for us, heaven seems like this place, this holy place, but what if it's here? What if here is the real heaven, and here is a simulation, but out there in the real world, it's terrible, man, it's awful. What if that's it? What if we're really living in heaven right now, and all these religious people, all these people are just trying to get into heaven? What if we're in heaven? Seems pretty counterintuitive, but one could argue that the religious people are doing good. And I don't want to get a religion, but, because, yeah, there's definitely some benefits, but there's also some, you know, it's brought unity, but it's also brought war, it's brought violence, but it's also brought peace, you know what I mean? It's this paradoxical thing that shouldn't be paradoxical, but it is, because, you know, there's not that much politics in it, but there's a lot of it has to do with money, but pretty much everything does, but I don't know. Okay, I don't know if I talked about Scientology up in this bitch, but, yeah. That shit's interesting, man. That shit is interesting. I want to look into that. That's another thing. I want to go into, I was thinking, I saw this because I saw a Jehovah's Witness church. And, you know, they're a little, there are people, in a word. No, I'm just joking about that. But they're extreme a bit, and I just kind of wanted to go in, plan to infiltrate, and ask them some questions. I'm not gonna be a fucking rude dick. Like I'm not gonna be like you fucking idiots. Like no, I'm not gonna do that. I'm literally gonna be curious in what they say and respectful enough so that I can get the most information out of them as possible. And get their viewpoint and see a lot of viewpoints. Now I'll talk about that. But the real one, and I lived in New Hampshire. Like, the fuck? I don't know if there's a Scientology thing in New Hampshire, a Scientology church in New Hampshire. But if there is, I am going to ask about that. And the thing I'm wondering about, is I want to see how much, I might need to go to both. Or even just a normal Christian church. Because I want to see how much each church, if I'm saying I don't know much about this religion, but it intrigues me, and just kind of leave it at that, leave it very vague, see it like I'm interested. I want to see how strongly each religion really tries to push me into their little circle. Because that, especially with Scientology, if they're trying to get me to, like, they're really pushing for me to get in, then that's just even furthermore proof that it really is just about the money. It really is. Because there's a fucking fee to join that. There's like a, it's like 500, I don't even know how much money it is. Look that shit up. But like, it's actually fucking crazy. It's, the shit it was founded. I might have already talked about it, but even if I did, I might have talked about it in the last one. But yeah, so it's pretty crazy. It was created by this guy named like Stephen Hubbard. Let me look it up. Scientology founder. L. Ron Hubbard. So, L. Ron Hubbard, he was a fiction writer, actually, and he made a book called Modern Science of Mental Health. I was fucking reading off that because I forgot that part. And that's largely what, I'm not saying that that part's fiction. He also wrote, like, a lot of sci-fi fiction. And I'll get to that later, but, well, not later, like, in a couple seconds. Wait, hold up. What the fuck? Holy shit. Jesus, that's expensive. I'm gonna just... Sorry, just wow. Scientologists must attend auditing. Essentially the church's term for therapy, which costs $800 an hour. And I am familiar with what that is. Well, not super familiar. Never done it, never... Don't know that. I haven't looked that deep into it. But what it is, it's essentially therapy. What they do is the auditor, the person running it, they have this machine. I think, I don't know what it's called. Audit something, and it all revolves around that. It's this piece, it works similar to like a lie detector test. Like it kind of blips up and down according to what they're talking about. But instead of lying, it's talking about traumas. So... not traumas, but situations. Like, he brings something up about, like, your past or something, and when you start to talk about it, if it's really traumatic for you, it's supposed to go up. And, then the auditor knows to keep talking about that thing to kind of pinpoint what maybe might be the traumatic experience and how to fix it and how to help you as a person, which all sounds great and cool. But it's $800 an hour. And they, usually, it says, these expensive auditing sessions can last a minimum of 2.5 hours each. So, it's literally $2,000. I feel like that's so purposeful. If it's $800 an hour and the minimum is 2.5 hours, that's a guaranteed $2,000 for each session. Each session. And I don't look how much they... That's kind of interesting. The Church of Scientology states it has no set dogma on God and allows individuals to come to their own understanding of God. In Scientology, vastly more emphasis is given to the godlike nature of the person and to the workings of the human mind than to the nature of God. It's interesting. But anyways, so yeah, back to that auditing thing. That shit's fucked up. But also, oh shit, what was the other thing I was looking up? Oh, L. Ron Hubbard. So, he wrote a book, Modern Mental Health, or whatever it's called. Sorry, I don't remember the name. And, and that's largely what, Scientology, it's all about, boosting the individual, and it's all about the individual. It's not like, it's nothing selfish. If you read what is in it, their rules and all that shit, not like their rules, but what they believe in, it sounds very good on paper. Very, very good. Everything on there is, but that's just it's the bare surface. It's, I can't even begin to tell you what the surface is. It's like, it's nothing. So what the beliefs were is, like just staying healthy mentally and all of this great stuff. I'll read it actually. Fuck it, dude. It's gonna be scuffed as shit, but, super unorganized, but that's just how it is, you know, I guess. Virtual Church, we'll tab on L. Ron Hubbard. And while I pull this up, the fiction he wrote sci-fi. In the origins, I'm not exactly sure. If you guys want to look up, like, just Scientology on YouTube, you'll find stuff about it and people exposing it for what it is. Beliefs and practices, there you are. And, it's basically a money sham at the end of the day. But anyways, He wrote sci-fi fiction, and he wrote this one book that never got published. And the plot of the book is the plot of, not like the plot, but like what Scientology believes to be the origin of man. Which I don't know what it is, but I know it involves some sort of the universe being created, and there's some sort of evil thing, and it got released. The evil, like, there's some name for it, the evil demon type thing got released into this world, and it inhabits all of us. That's what it is. It inhabits all of us, and you need to go to auditing so you can be cleared. That's a term to be, I don't know if it's to be clear or cleared, or like clear, I don't know. It's something to do with clear. I know that. And I'm guessing it's clearing, ridding themselves of that, like, demon thing. So they put this idea that people are, like, dirty with this demon-type thing. There's some certain name for it, but I don't know what it is, and I don't want to look it up, because that'd just be annoying. And yeah, they put this idea in people's head that there's something inside of them that's evil, and they need to go to this $800 an hour session that will clear them from it. I'm assuming. I am not sure, but I know auditing or something of that nature is called clearing. And that's like the first step in Scientology, is to be cleared. So yes. Oh, background and origins. Huh? Okay, that is beginnings. This is fucking crazy. Just check out this fucking website. Holy shit. The auditor's code. Oh no, that's for the auditor. That's for the fucking... the code of a Scientologist. Here we go. To keep Scientologists as public and press accurately informed concerning Scientology, the world of mental health and society. Okay. To use the best I know of Scientology to the best of my ability to help my family, friends, group, and the world. To refuse to accept for processing and refuse to accept money from any pre-clear or group I feel I cannot honestly help. Pre-clear. To decry and do all I can to abolish any and all abuses against life and mankind, to expose and help abolish any and all physically damaging practices, all of this. To embrace a policy of equal justice for all, the work for freedom of speech in the world. Oh my god, man. That is... see, the interesting thing about that, actually, is I've never heard this point, but... when was Scientology founded? I believe... okay. So it came out in 1953. Yes. That does add up. This might be a stretch. No, I don't think it is, though. To work for freedom of speech and all in the world. To support the freedom of religion. These are things that are American fundamentals, right? This is what America is built on. Freedom. All of this stuff. This religion was founded in 1953, okay? I'm getting kind of all nerdy here. But in 1953, we're in Civil War. The Cold War. This war has gone on for about 6 years. And if you guys didn't know, I mean, unless you're like 10 or like 8 or some shit, I'll get off my video. And two, it was a war between us and Russia. There was actually no fighting. It was basically just threats and a lot of like spying, espionage, and things of that nature. And there was the arms race and the space race. Basically just, it was a war of who would be the world superpower, essentially. So, what America did was the government, they and everyone to kind of have support in this and all of that. There was a lot of propaganda against Russia, and there was a lot of not necessarily propaganda, but there's a lot of stuff like all about freedom and all about that sort of stuff. It was very like American time, like it was very capitalism versus communism, all of that, all like American ideals versus them, that we want to be the superpower because we want our ideals to be showcased in the world. We don't want the biggest superpower to be a communist state and everyone converting to communism. So, the interesting thing, that all ties into Scientology because that started in 1947. Now, this started in 1953, and out of the 20 rules, there is a few about, and this might be a stretch, but it says freedom to use Scientology's philosophy in all its applications, to support the freedom of religion, to support or to work for freedom of speech in the world, you know, to embrace the policy of equal justice for all, things America is all about, okay? So, what I think is this ties into the part that this is all a money sham. It 100% is. And I hope me posting this somehow doesn't go viral. I honestly hope this does not go viral at all. Don't expect it to, but I hope it doesn't. Because I really want to go to a Scientology church and fucking, or whatever it's called, and just fucking just ask them questions, like, face to face. I don't think they're going to, like, kill me or some shit. But, yeah, that is a... Shit, dog! Okay. Boom. Did not know this was going to happen. Okay, shit's going to get a little weird, but it's fine. That's weird. Don't mind it. It's fine. And, yeah. There we are. Nope. There we are. Okay. And there we go. All right. Taking a personality test. Ah. Very good. Okay. So, this is even furthermore proof, because to start the test, you need to give them your email. And give them, actually, wow, they're asking for a lot of stuff. They're asking for your aid, okay, yeah. So, that actually was even more beneficial than actually taking their test. Because it shows they just want your information, they want to see who's interested. It's almost like they're looking for demographics so that they can appeal certain ideals to the younger audience or the older audience, or appeal to whoever their demographic is so that they can make the most money. Which, again, might be a stretch. They might honestly just be a great group, but I've seen a lot of stuff, like Beyonce's friend, all that shit. And this isn't even conspiracy theory. It's literally, like, confirmed. And I don't really believe in a lot of conspiracy theories. I've never really looked into some shit. Like, I've looked into, like, sometimes I watch the Joe Rogan podcast, and I'm gonna end this pretty quick here, just talk about this for a little bit. And he had Eddie Bravo on, which is another, like, jiu-jitsu guy, and he's a big conspiracy theory guy. And yeah, I looked into the flat earth. You know, some flat earthers think Antarctica is a sham as well, and Antarctica is actually a wall that's creating this dome-like thing around the flat earth, and that's why, and people can't fall off that way. But it's like, why don't people ever see the dome? Like, and they'd be like, well, because it's Antarctica, it's far away from everything. But if the Earth was flat, like, how does latitude and longitude even work? Because there's so many questions. Who was it? Fucking Joe Rogan asked Eddie Bravo, like, okay, then how are we rotating? How are we spinning? And he was like, we're not. Like, what? And then he pulled up some fact that he thought was true. And then Joe has a research guy, kind of like what I do on the spot. I mean, but I'm my own research guy. I don't have a Jamie to look shit up for me. I wish I did. But that's basically what his job is. And he looked up to fact check that, and he was wrong. He said the experiment that they were trying to do to prove that the Earth wasn't spinning couldn't be recreated. And that's like a big no-no in science. It means it's just not true. Because if something can't be recreated, it means it's not true. Well, at least in the science world, that's not always factual, but it's pretty good rule of thumb. But yeah, so flat earthers think the world isn't spinning and that Antarctica is surrounding us. And again, I don't understand just like so many things, like, what is the real map of the world? Is it just the map? The flat earthers' map of the world. Okay, flat earth maps. The flat earth, they have a whole wiki? They got a wiki? Okay, this is kind of, shit, dog. Hit him with it. Ooh. Okay, it's probably a really shitty spot to put it, but Flat Earth maps. So it is circular. Square and stationary Earth. What? Huh? This is from 1893. Wait, when was the globe first? When was the Earth shape discovered? I just don't know how to word that. Okay, so I guess. So there's that. I did not know that was that old of an idea. Okay, anyways, the cosmos. Oh, they also think space is not. Eddie Bravo was saying he doesn't believe all the shit. He said he didn't believe space isn't real. He just said he doesn't believe all the shit NASA and all the governments are saying about space. All the stuff, like, landed on the moon. And that's actually a pretty popular conspiracy theory. But, he's thinking, like, we don't know. Literally, NASA Earth pictures. He brought up Japanese government or whatever their space program is. They have a satellite and they take pictures from the Earth like 12,000 miles away or like some really fucking far distance away. And that is, yeah, so Earth images. And it's literally images of the Earth. And that's it. And he brought up one that was very far away. Like, this is, like, the really far away one, and it was just, like, a circle. You know what I mean? It literally just looked like a circle. And he thought it looked fake, and Joe was like, but you don't know anything about, you're not a professional imagery or whatever the fuck he said. Like, you've no idea what he's saying. It just looks fake. He's like, you've no background in that. How do you know it's fake? He's like, you didn't have a background to know something's fake. It's like, but, like, well, the thing I don't get, another great point he brought up, was what do governments have to gain about the Earth being a circle or not? He's like, I don't know. Like, okay. This is interesting. The tides. Oh my god. Oh my god. Shit, sorry boys. That's a scuff. That's scuffed up. Shit, I gotta fix it. Fuck, dude. Shit. Are we fucking kidding me? This guy sounds so smart. Just kidding. But he, like, sounds smart, you know what I'm saying? Okay, boom.
And the high tide might be a meter above sea level, and that would be a tidal amplitude of 2 meters, which is considered very high. And those high tidal amplitudes are here in red. So this is where the difference between the low tide and the high tide is the greatest.
Thank you.
What you'll notice with this is that there are places where the tidal amplitude is very, very low. It's actually zero. And those are the places here in pink. In these places, there is no tide.
Okay.
Low tide is the same as high tide. What that translates to is zero tidal amplitude. So every place in pink has zero tide. Now, the places where there is no tide, these are called amphidromic points. I will call them tidal nodes because that's the more commoner term for them. And they're here. And these are the places, these points, that there is no tide. Literally no tide at all. And there's tons of them all over this map. There's these ones in the center of the oceans, which are quite easy to see.
Imagine you just made this shit up.
But if you look closely at this map,
amphidromic
points, tidal nodes, you'll see there's also a number of much smaller ones that operate in smaller regions. I'm going to circle these three. Look, there's three tidal nodes. These are areas, again, with no tide, where the water is still all year long, all day long, all week long, no tide. Here's another one here. you can see three in here. You start seeing them when you look. You start seeing them all over the place here.
Wait, shit.
See, there's actually three up here in Upper Canada. Now, the greatest density of these that I have seen is in the Polar Sea. Now, this is a polar projection map. This is a favorite by flat earthers. And you can see how many of these nodes are in the Arctic Sea. This is the Arctic Sea up here, the North Polar Sea. You can see all the nodes in here. I'm just circling them all. These are places with no tide. This is just a zoom in on that so you can see. It's almost fractal how this looks because you've got all these little nodes here and then you've also got all big nodes all in the sea. Oh, that's where the purples are. These big tidal nodes. These seem to be the center of what's going on with the tides. This is a better chart of the polar sea. So this is, again, a North Polar projection. I've placed a big X on the North Pole. And you can see even more in here. It seems almost like there's too many to count. Like there's areas where they're just extremely dense, these tidal nodes. So I think there's even some on these islands. These don't have to be underwater, and I'll talk about that later as well. Look at this. It seems like there's three in a row in here. All these tiny little tidal nodes. It's almost fractal how this seems to work. There's two here. This is Hudson's Bay in Canada, and I'm going to talk about that later. But first, this is the Mediterranean. There's also tidal nodes in the Mediterranean. It's not as dense, maybe, as in the Polar Sea. This is another one that's on land, actually. And I think it looks like there's one here. You can see this is Cyprus, so that's sort of how the Mediterranean here is aligned. This is the North Sea near the United Kingdom, and you can see these two tidal nodes here, as well as a tidal node which they've clearly marked on Sweden or Norway. That
Wait,
would be
what
in
the
Norway.
Fuck?
I've also got this side by side with an actual animation. Now, what's nice about this animation, it shows tides. It doesn't just show tidal amplitude. It shows tides in real time. And you can see how high these tides are relatively. These are these huge 2 or 3 meter tides that are all rushing up through this English Channel here. And yet you do have a tidal
node.
Yeah,
isn't that very how people calculate?
Like, so you've
how
got these massive
the waves are going to be? Isn't that a thing? Can't people know how big waves are going to be that day or some shit? Whatever, man. Whatever.
Tides, but you actually have a tidal node around here. Now, this model doesn't show the tidal nodes amazing because you can see some of the tide go in through here. But it's pretty good here where you can see the tide's up on this side, then it's up on this side. It's up on this side.
All right,
and then
this shit got weird, dog. I'm gonna end her here. Got a little. I said it was gonna be 10. I said it was going to stop 28 minutes ago, but it just kind of started rolling. But anyways, we didn't even get to the Flat Earth Society. So we're going to do that for sure. Frequently asked questions. What is the Flat Earth Society? It's derived from many different facets of science and philosophy. No, it's not. The movement of the sun. These are all examples of your senses telling you that we do not live in a... Oh, another thing I don't understand is how does the sun and moon cycle work? Like, you know, it goes around the Earth. Like, the moon revolves around the Earth. Am I wrong? Does the moon not revolve around the Earth? Yeah, I'm 90% sure it does. Yeah, exactly. So, so I don't understand how that would rotate around a flat planet. What is the definition of a planet? I feel like... a celestial body. Now, do flat earthers think we are... revolving around the Earth? Or not the Earth, the Sun? think the moon is flat. Flat earthers. And religion. So this ties against religion. That's interesting. Whoa. Accidentally a double R, boys. Is flat earth theory connected to religion? Oh. Both mainstream and otherwise, let's use followers of the... The most commonly accepted explanation of this is that the space agency of the world are involved in a conspiracy. The most commonly accepted, as if it's an open-ended question. It's not. It has to be a fact. What the fuck? The most commonly accepted explanation of this is that the space agencies of the world are involved in a conspiracy faking space travel and exploration. The conspiracy. Oh, boys. Boys. We're gonna stop here and this... We're gonna pick it back up. But, yeah. This has been it. And, actually, I hope you fucking... I don't know if I'm serious in saying this, but I'm pretty sure I am. I really hope you die after watching this video. Like, right now, so I can get your view. But, that's not how views work. But anyways, yeah, so fuck you. Go fuck yourself. Fuck you some more. And fuck you.